What's up, everybody? Dave Bartosiak here, and I have another chart of the day for you, as promised. That's right. Today, we're talking about Tempus AI, ticker T-E-M. This one popped up on my radar because I like to follow several different names on X, formerly known as Twitter. And among them, there is a stock tracker dedicated to members of Congress buying stuff. So in this case, Nancy Pelosi initiated, I think, 50 of the $20 Jan 26 calls on Tempus AI. That was announced on like the 14th. And since then, it's been doing pretty well. So take a look at this. January 14th, this stock, or the trade was made on the 14th. I think it was announced on the 17th. 31.83 here back then. Now it's doubled. Here we are at 62. So pretty exciting move. Obviously, a lot of these AI names have been rocking and rolling. This one's no different. This is a medical AI company. So hasn't even been around that long. All we have here is a 50-day moving average. I don't even have a 200-day because it hasn't even traded for 200 days. So not that much info to work with. We do have the big gap up here on the 21st of January, something to keep in mind. And look at these all-time highs up here. So close to $80 on this stock. So even this latest run up still hasn't touched that. You do have this sort of swing high in December, 68.95. So that's obviously going to be an area of resistance should the stock get up there. Another thing I want to point out, earlier today, I took a sneak peek at the short interest, and it's like 22% short interest. So there's a huge short position. These guys obviously brought plenty of supply when it spiked up here and again here. And it looked like, you know, things were going pretty rough for the stock. But this big spike up has now broken this sort of trend line down across the tops. And now we're in a whole new world. And obviously, a lot of these AI names are helping with that. You had Palantir after the bell yesterday, up over 25% today. So it's all helping. Now, speaking of yesterday, and yesterday was Monday, February 3rd, stock had a pretty good day, had a 7% day. Opening down at 53.63. Of course, the whole market sort of gapped down on the tariff news. Then we're pausing tariffs. Markets rallying again. And it closed at 61.54 yesterday, up 7%. So far this morning, we had a gap up, which was sold off pretty much all day. And that's what we've got going on here. So volumes have picked up considerably also. This is a stock back when it was at its previous highs. It really was barely trading anything, right? Talking a million shares, maybe 3 million here on a good day. That bumped up pretty significantly in December to 4, 5, 6 million. And then now, ever since the rest of us caught wind of that trade in Congress, you had nearly 34 million that day. Kind of subsided a little bit, but still, this thing is going to trade 10, 15, 20 million shares pretty much every day. So it is on the radar, my friends. When you start digging in the fundamentals, it's not the greatest thing on earth, but hey, this is a chart of the day. This is a day, you know, fundamental analysis here. So what do we want to do to gain some perspective? So let's just go ahead and do this. Let's go from the highs down to the lows, see where some of these levels might be from a retracement standpoint. And you can see that 23.6, that first gap up, really opened there and bumped its head on that 38.2. So these have already sort of come into play. And you got this other rally that hits right in the 50. See where I'm going here? 61.8 is the level I would actually keep an eye on for today. And then up above that, we have that 69.28, which is pretty close to this swing high. So there are your lines in the sand that you need to worry about. Now, this big spike up today that's been sold off all day, you want to look to see if that starts to get down in yesterday's range, because that could be a sign of a reversal in the short term. Now, should they step in and buy that, you know, then we're still going to be trending higher. So today is actually a very important day. And by the time this video comes out, we're going to know the fate, right? So around 4 o'clock today, go ahead in the comment section, tell me where this thing closes here on February 4th. And then we can discuss whether that's going to keep on selling off, or it's going to go up. I think if it closes underneath this fib level, that it's going to retrace here. And if it closes above, then I think we're free and clear to challenge these highs, especially on a little bit of good news. You do have the volume picking up. A lot of good stuff going on. That is Tempus AI, ticker TEM, and it is a Zacks rank number 3 hold right now. So pretty much neutral from our perspective. All right, folks, there you have it for my chart of the day. Be sure to follow the author if you're here on Zacks.com so you get all of my chart of the day videos as they come. A little bit of a misnomer. I do about 2 a week. So it's a chart for that day and that day, but I can't call it chart of the week because we're doing it twice a week. Anywho, go ahead and subscribe to the YouTube channel and come back tomorrow for my next chart of the day. For everybody here at Zacks.com, I'm Dave Bartosiak, and I will see you then. Thanks.